Now you can see I have used the calculated resistors, that is RSS, to produce a multi-voltmeter. So we have to we have a selector switch, and all these resistors are coming in series. So we can switch to anything. So if you switch to RS equals 0, that is the direct connection of the galvanometer right to the circuit, the range will be 0 to 2 volts. If you connect it to 80, the range will be 0 to 10 volts. If you connect it to 980, the range will be 0 to 100 volts. And if you connect it to 9980, the range will be 0 to 1000 volts. Right? So we have a multi-voltmeter. So as we did before, we can also have a different configuration for this, right? So to do that, press here, and what I do is, from the positive terminal, I have the first tapping. Without series resistance, then I'll have 80 ohm, and from the 80 ohm I take a tapping that will give me a 0 to 10 volts range, right? Then I'll put 80, the balance 980 is the next one, so I reduce 80, so it comes to 900 now. 900 ohm. So these two combination will give 980 if we are connected to this one. So that will give 0 to 100 volts, right? Again, okay, I'll take the tapping here. Then I'll put 980 is already there. I have to put 9000 now. And connect it to this one. So this range, you can see, we for 1000 volts range we wanted 9980. For 100 volts range we wanted 980. For 10 volts range we wanted 80, and without series resistance it will measure 0 to 2 volts. So this is also another way of doing monthly voltmeter. Take it down. So the last portion is the general equation and the graph for a multi-voltmeter. So we have a voltage to be measured, and then series resistor RS plus galvanometer, and this is say RG, or the total, the voltage across this is VG, and we have IG here, right? So if you write an equation, V measured is IG into RS right? Plus I can write Ig into Rg, or we can directly write Vg, because this Ig and Vg are constant for a given meter, right? So that is, the FSDs are constant. Right? So if we change RS, we can get a new range. Then this is a message voltage or range, right? So the by changing series resistance, we can change the range. So this is something like Y equal MX plus C. So if you draw a graph between V measured or range versus RS, you get a graph like this, right? So for various combination of RS, you can find the range, right? For various combinations of RS, you can find the range, right? So if you put 80, 980, 9980, the values that we calculated, this will be 1000, this will be 100, and this will be 10. Okay, so when it is 0, this will be 2. Sorry, this will be 2. Deflection is proportional to current, and we also derive the deflection is proportional to voltage also, right? So in this case, for the deflection to take place, we need some current, or we need some voltage to produce that current, right? But in the case of when you measure a resistor, when you try to measure a resistor for its resistance value R, if you connect a galvanometer directly, there is no current. It cannot produce a current. Right? The resistor is a passive element, passive device. But compared to a circuit, in a circuit, there will always be a current source, a voltage source, right? A battery will be there, and that is why we are measuring current and voltages. So in order to power the galvanometer, there will be a current, a voltage. But whereas in when you directly measure resistance, you can't give a current to deflect this. So we can't use it directly. The galvanometer cannot be used directly to measure resistances, right? So therefore, we need to provide an external supply. When it comes to converting galvanometer into a ohm meter, right? So we'll see how we can do this. I'll first draw the diagram. Okay, let's look at this diagram. Right? This is the resistance to be measured, unknown resistance. Resistance to be measured. So this is the arrangement. Because we don't have current to be produced in the passive resistor, we introduced a cell here. Say this is E, right? Then we have the galvanometer. Now this is the arrangement. Now we have to calibrate it, right? When the dial is calibrated, we have to find the extreme values first. So what are the extreme values? Now when in a galvanometer setup reading, this what you are using is a galvanometer. The lowest range is 100, lowest value, and maximum value is 100 milliamps. This is the galvanometer that we used, right? Now that is what we are using now. This IG is 100. Now we have to calibrate the scale for ohm meter, right? So what I am going to do is the extreme values I am going to calculate, right? So the extreme value of zero, the zero current is produced when the resistance to be measured is infinite, right? When the resistance to be measured is infinite, when Rx equal infinity, the infinitely large resistance, that is infinity means open circuit, right? That means there is no connection. We remove this, right? We remove this. Rx is zero, infinity, right? So when Rx is infinity, no current will flow, right? So that means when galvanometer dial is zero, this corresponds to infinite resistance. Okay. Now the other extreme is the maximum current can flow when these two are short circuited, right? When the external resistance is zero, right? So this is like short circuit, right? When it is short circuited, Rx is zero. When Rx is zero, what is the current? Ig. The only resistance that we have is Rg, right? So the voltage is E. So E divided by Rg. Now this should be, Ig should be 100 milliamps, right? And this is always 20 ohm for our example, right? It doesn't need to be 20 ohm, but in our example 20 ohm. So we have to have a cell that can give Ig 100 milliamps, right? So that cell voltage will be so the modified circuit will be instead of using a fixed E, we leave the E some flexibility and we introduce a resistor here, that is RS. This is a variable resistor, just we can change it to tune it, right? So the if you try to redo the previous calculations for Rx equal to infinity, right? So the current Ig will be zero. When Rx is zero, that is other extreme, the Ig will be E divided by Rg plus Rs, right? Rg plus Rs. Now we know that Rg is constant, right? Say we use a fixed E, right? Fixed cell, voltage fixed. Now by changing Rs, we can bring Ig to 100 milliamps. By changing Rs, we can bring Ig to 100 milliamps. So our scale now 0 to 100 milliamps. Now it is rescaled for the ohms scale. Now this side Ig is 0 when Rx is infinity. Ig 0, this is Ig, this is Rx, right, infinity. Then on the other end we get when Ig is 100 milliamps we have Rs, right? Sorry, when Rx is 0, when Rx is 0 we have Ig 100 milliamps, that is set by changing Rs, right? So that is a new scale. Now we can calculate the common equation is when Rx is present, Ig equal E divided by Rs plus Rg plus Rx, right? So this is the equation, and we can now recalibrate this. Now we don't know the middle values, right, in between values, so we can calibrate it. First you copy this again. So if you assume Ig is 100 milliamps, Rg is 20 ohm, and the E is 3 volts, right? For Rx 0, that is a full scale deflection, Rx 0 is the full scale deflection, the maximum current is going to flow when Rx is 0. Now this is another important thing you have to notice is that this scale is reversed, right? For voltmeter and ammeter, the lower value is on the left and the higher value is on the right. But for the ohmmeter, the higher value is on the left, lower value is on the right, right? Resistance 0 is here, resistance infinity is here, okay? Right. So when Rx is 0, that will be the Rx 0, means that corresponds to 100 milliamps. Now we have to calculate what is the series resistance we need for this case. So Ig equal E divided by Rs plus Rg plus Rx. In that case Rx is 0, so when Rx is 0, the full scale deflection is received. So Ig is 100 milliamps, is equal to 3 volts divided by Rs, we don't know, plus Rg is 20 ohm, right? So Rs plus Rg, Rs plus 20, equal to 3 divided by 100 into 10 to the power 3, right? Minus 3, I'm taking it to the this will be 30, therefore Rs is 10 ohm. So the series resistor that should be connected or tuned is 110 ohms, right? Rs is 10 ohms. So once you tune Rs to 10 ohms, you fixed it. You don't change it after that, right? Because Rs we always tune it for full scale deflection, right? So full scale deflection, we tune the Rs and keep it there. We don't change it after that. So the Rs is fixed after that. Rg is also fixed. Now we can measure different values of Rx, right? So we will calculate the in-between values. Now, whether to see this, how this is distributed. Now, you know that in this case, this is 0 to 100. This will be 50 milliamps in the middle point, right? 3 quarter is 75 milliamps. Quarter is 25 milliamps. Now, we can corresponding values, the resistance values, we can calculate. right? So from this equation, Ig equal E upon Rs plus Rg plus Rx, right? So we have to find Rx now. So if you take it that way, and E upon Ig minus Rs plus Rg, right? E is 3 volts, Ig is 100 milliamps. Ig is okay, we leave it like that. Now we will see when Ig is 50 milliamps, what is the resistance, right? So E, we know Ig equal 50 milliamps, Rx is 3 divided by 50 into 10 to the power minus 3 minus Rs plus Rg is 30, right? 20 plus 10, right? What is Rx now? This take it 3000, 50 minus 30, cut, this is 60 minus 30, that is 30, right? 30 ohm. Now if you calculate the other values for Ig equal 25 milliamps, so I'll mark this first, the 30 ohm. So when Ig is 50 milliamps, this will be 30 ohm. When Ig is 25 milliamps, the Rx will be, you can calculate similarly, Rx will be 120 ohm. And when Ig is 75 milliamps, Rx is 90 ohm. This will be 10 ohm, right? So you can calculate and see. So if I mark this in the scale, this will be 10 ohm, this will be 120 ohm. Now this is our new scale now. Now you can see this dial is non-linear, right? In a voltage scale or a current scale, the scale is linear, right? So the middle point is 50, when the full scale deflection is 100, and 75, 25. The corresponding resistance values are not linear, right? The 25% is 10 ohm, 50% is 30 ohm, 75% is 120 ohm, 90 ohm, and the full scale value is infinity. So this is a non-linear scale. So if you look at the ohm meter, usually you can see this dial, the scale like this. Initially it will be very, you know, the lines will be very apart to each other, but as you go into the higher values, the scaling will be very tight, and when it comes to here, it will be like this. So if you can see that in an actual multimeter or ohm meter, it will be congested here. The dial markings will be congested here, where it will be very far to each other on the right side, right? So it's a non-linear scale, whereas ammeter or voltmeter scales are linear scales, right? And other important thing is, you can see this Ig. This Ig, from Ig only we are calculating this Rx, right? This is depending, this Rx values are measurements are depending on E, that is the electromotive force of the cell we used, right? So because it is depending on E, we need to keep E constant, because we assume a constant value. Now in this example case, right, in the example case we assumed a 3 volt cell, right? So throughout the measurement, right, whenever we do measurement, this voltage should remain in 3 volts. If it is changing, our calculation will be changed, our calibration will be changed, right? This is one disadvantage in an ohm meter, right? The scale is depending on E, right? Another thing is the scale is non-linear, right? And also we have to make sure that every time we make sure that the cell is long lasting. For example, if you use a normal primary cell, the voltage will be varying with time, the usage, right? Every time we use it, the voltage will drop, right? So we have to use a more stabilized voltage source, right, if you want to use it as a ohm meter, right? So that is about ohm meter. I think you can copy this first. Okay, I wanted to finish this with the drawing of the multimeter, but because the time is now up, so what we can do is, now you can go through, now we have already done ammeter, voltmeter and ohm meter using galvanometers, so you know the configuration. You have to first refer to voltmeter, multi-voltmeter, multi-ammeter, then multi-voltmeter.